Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today? Are you up now? Okay. It's okay. It's okay to be a little bit sleepy, so we have a coffee outside. And also, please do use your card, okay? Everybody has a card? This is the your ticket for fall semester. It'll come handy because trust me, okay? You'll have sleepless nights. We have gourmet coffee. It's under our cubicle, so please do come use it. But you have to recite, right? So that's why. Why don't we recite one time? Let's recite one more time.
How good and pleasant it is when brothers live together in unity.
So we pray to be brothers in unity. Our brother Jesus and we all brothers. So let's look at it. Okay. So today is a 9-1-1, right? So 9-1-1, this is a historical day. So the day will live in infamy. So 9-1-1. But if you want to travel, this is the cheapest time to fly. Please do take advantage of the fly overseas, okay? That's what my son is doing, so that's good. I never thought that he's a economy major, but he'll be rich, you know, in the future. So go to Europe and go to 9-1-1, okay? We are doing a series. I'm trying to give a big picture. So I'm excited about the Bible, and I really want to see people get excited about the Bible. Okay? And then there are many ways to think about the Bible, but I want to think about four ways. Okay? The Bible has what? The creation, and the fall. What's wrong with ourselves? And then redemption and restoration. So we'll do redemption today. Okay? But I need your help today. Let's do it together. First of all, I want you to look good. Right? So I think there's no problem with that. Jerry Kelly is here, he looks good. I don't have no problem. And then Tiffany is here, so okay, that's good. You look good, right? And then help me out, because last week some people complained I'm soft. Can you believe that? I'm loud, but I think the sound system, okay? It's not me. So if you cannot hear me, then please raise hand. And also nudge, okay, Isaiah or Jeremiah Park, okay? Then we'll pump up value, okay? Can you do two things? First thing, what? You look good, okay? And if you cannot hear me, what? It's okay to say, you know, Sam, speak up or something like that, okay? Right? Or if you don't know anything, just let me know. Then I'll go one more time. Okay, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your grace of Jesus. We come to you, and we are coming from all different places. Some people are sleepy, and some people are refreshed. Some people are happy, and some people are sad. But grant us your word, and then help us to put our trust in you, especially the word of God today. Grant us grace to listen to you, empowered by Spirit, and share the good news of God by serving your people and our Lord Jesus Christ. I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay, so our text is Hosea. So we are ambitious today, okay? But we'll make it short. Three chapters of Hosea, and there are 14 chapters. So I tried to cut to 14 chapters, but it'll take all day, but so I'll do three chapters. And the key verse is Hosea 3, 1, and 2. So can we share the Bible and then look at the Bible and recite it together? This is my main point. Hosea verses 1 and 2. Okay. Why don't you get let's read 1 and 3, okay? I'll give you extra points, okay? Bonus. Okay? So let's go.
And I told her, you are truly a Jew, and many days,
Okay, let's read one more time. Are you up? So this is the most beautiful story. Okay. God, this is a love story. You cannot beat this. So let's, girls, I need your help, okay? Guys are clueless, but anyway. So, let's read together, okay? Okay. The Lord is faithful. Said to me, Hosea, go show your love to your wife again. This is one of the most beautiful stories of the Bible. Okay, so this is my plan. I'll talk about the story of Hosea. I'll just summarize chapters 1 and 3. And then we are a gospel organization, so we'll talk about who God is in Hosea and then who we are. And then we will briefly talk about what's the relationship between redemption and Jesus. And then the fundamental question is, I always ask, so what? Okay. So what does this story teach us about God and about us? And this story has to change you. So let's pray that through this story, we can get hope, receive God's love, and be transformed by the goodness of God. So that's my plan. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, help us to listen to you today. Please forgive all our sins, and then help us to meet you today and think about who God is and who we are before God. And please help us to not to forget our Lord Jesus Christ, who redeemed us through his blood. I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, I'll give you a simple definition of redemption, okay? Redemption is what? Redemption is you're paying off something. So how many people have a credit card? Okay, lots of credit card debts, isn't there?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. So, and then you pay off, that's a redemption, right? That's basically, the simple is that your sins has been paid by Jesus. And then our God, that's our redemption. So, Hosea and Gomer, this one is some marriage themes going on here. So it's Hosea and then Gomer's marriage, okay? How many people are married here? Raise your hand. Come on, those are married, please raise your hand. Those who are not married, please hand. Not married? Not married? Those who want to live by yourself for the rest of your life.
Oh, yeah. No.
But I want to propose today that you are all married. Whether you are not, whether you acknowledge or not, we are all married people. Okay. The story comes with what? The first, if you look at verse 2, I think verse 2. Then the Lord began to speak through Hosea. The Lord said to him, this is a very wonderful message, no? Go and marry. Right? Go and marry. Guys, go and marry. Aren't you excited about that? No? I'm happy. Go and marry. You know? But Hosea's story is not a very typical marriage story. Because I attended one wedding in Washington. This is Susan Lee. And then, I'm not sure the guy's name, but I know woman's name. I'm not sure who's the name. Looks cute, okay? Ilya. Not Hosea. So, how do you marry? So, typically in this country, guys, look hard, they look around this way, here and there, right? And then you meet the most beautiful girl you can find, right? And then you have this Bruno Mars moment. Bruno Mars moment, okay? And then you said, wow! It's like, you know, usually guys become blind, okay? And they say, you're perfect. When you smile at me, everything starts. Right? Just the way you are, like, right? Like you have this Bruno Mars moment, you know? I don't know. I had that moment, okay? And then, like, Bruno, and then everything stops. Nothing matters. PhD, no study, nothing matters. I can sleep and eat at the same time. Nothing matters. Right? And then, think about Hosea, okay? God said, go and marry. I liked it. Right? But he said, go and marry who? The Bruno Mars girl? No. God said, go and marry an adulterous wife. So you have to imagine Hosea, okay? Hosea is like, I'm trying to imagine what Hosea looks like, okay? Maybe Hosea looks like that, handsome guy, okay? Maybe Hosea looks like Jerry. Right? Even better, right? I'm trying to imagine maybe Hosea looks like, Mike, I don't know. I'm trying to think about that. And then Hosea got this message. And then imagine Hosea. So, Hosea married. He's an obedient guy, okay? He knows how to hear the word of God and then obey. And then, at that time, marriage is not like, we are thinking about this random marriage, okay? You marry somebody you like, okay? But at that time, the marriage involves a whole family, right? Whole clan. So, it's not enough that you get married, okay? So you have to get permission from your mom. And father. So I'm thinking this Hosea. Imagine Hosea going to bar. Not just bar, but the sleaziest bar. And then doing lots of investigation. And have to make sure that he's adulterous. And how do you know he's adulterous? Okay? And then maybe he drew the equations or something, I don't know. And then some test, okay? And then he brings his wife to be to his family. But he has to get his permission from father, right? And then I can imagine this Goma, okay? I'm trying to imagine this Goma, okay? How does she look like? She must be hot. Sizzling hot, you know? And she must be tattooed or something. I don't know, I don't know. So Hosea brings this Goma to parents, and then try to give a good story about Gomer. Hey, I met this girl. She's hot. Not only hot, but she's a lady, okay? A plus lady, adulterous lady, or something like that. But Jose has to hide that fact, okay? And then think about that. You know, guys have some ideas whom to marry, right? Can you marry Gomer? How many guys can raise hand and say, I want to marry Gomer? Jeremiah? No, he's just scratching his head. Okay. I thought he was raising hand.
A prostitute?
Yeah, known adulterers, okay? So, this is a crazy story. And I thought that this is a crazy command. Right? Mm. And then, so what does Hosea do? He does research, and he marries certified adulterous woman. Right? And then, Hosea had three children, right? The three children of Gomer and question mark, because God gives names to his children. The first baby's name is what? Jezreel means what? Massacre. Okay. Here is the. There are many instances guys will break down, but this is one instance. Okay. Suppose you marry a girl, and then she goes out and sleeps with another guy, and then brings a baby. It's a bloody. It's a massacre. There is a way to kill God. Okay? This is the case. Massacre. The guy will bleed and die. God says that that child is a bloody baby. And then, what's the second child name? What's it mean? No mercy. So, when you have a baby, the most important process is bonding with the baby. You know, my son came to me, and then, initial expression was, oh, this is so ugly. But after a while, I began to love. But suppose you are a child and your father says, I have no love for you because I don't know who your father is. I'm not your father. I don't love you. Right? And then what's the third one's name? Okay, that's a no, and then not my child, God said. All right. So, but I want to see Hosea from perspective. Hosea did not divorce this lady, okay? He bled. He's emotionally drained. I feel no love. And then what? It's not my child. Then God says, go and marry this woman. What will you do? I'll go crazy. At this point, I'll go crazy. I don't want to be a prophet of God. Let me do. But Hosea bores with a weakness and still loves you. Because, you know, legally, Hosea said, I married her. But Hosea did more than that. If you just marry, you can divorce, no? Because God's law says that when you have an adulterous wife, it's legal to divorce, right? But Hosea did not just follow the simple instruction, but he loved this lady from his heart, even though she stabbed him 3 times to his heart. And then things get crazier. Things are crazy. Okay, so suppose you are the Gomer. What will you do? That you have done something wrong to husband. And he's around. And then, he says that. Then maybe Gomer might be moved by Hosea's patience, kindness, what? Loving, And then he says in chapter 2, she goes after. She said, I'll go after my lovers. Lovers, like one lover, but it's a series of lovers. Right? Think about it, okay? Gomer had no chance of getting married. I'm serious. Guys, you're not going to marry this kind of woman. And then Hosea showed love, obeyed God, and married her. And then what she did was she went out and then get all the children of not her, Hosea's, okay? And Hosea loved her. And then what? Gomer says, oh, guess what? All my problems due to you. You're not a good husband. Right? You don't provide well, even though I gave you lots of things, and you restrict my freedom, okay? So, you are not a good lover. So I'll go after my lovers. And then she abandons her children. Abandons her loving husband. In doing so, she abandons God. And she thinks, oh, I am so brilliant. I'm so brilliant, And I go after lovers because, I don't need it because I have multiple things. I have plan A, plan B, and plan C. And then, what's the result? What is the result? She find satisfaction. She find joy. She find ecstasy. This is one of the most tragic story. Gomo was so hard. Gomo had everything. Gomo could have produced many children. And Gomo has a good husband. But Gomo abandoned everything and go after lovers. And she tried to chase the wind, but she couldn't chase it. And then chapter 3 comes. In chapter 3, Hosea is looking through the crack list, okay? Crack list, and then Urbana and Champagne. And then, oh, she found something, oil attachment, for sale, for sale. And it says, Gomo was on the paper, crack list, for sale. Damaged good. And then when I look at this, what's the Hosea's response? If I were Hosea, I said, I'm happy, I'm so happy. Okay? I'm so happy. Let's go out and drink, okay? And celebrate, because she deserved this kind of treatment, okay? For sale. And then she became a slave. She became a damaged good. She's not as pretty as more, right? And then look at the sales price. And then let's look at it. The price of her sale, okay? If you want to buy a slave, the legal price is 30 shekels, okay? All right now, if you look at it, how much, what's going price for her? 15 shekels, okay? Plus one bag of barley, okay? So that means she's not even useful, okay? Okay, suppose she's, you know, I look at the shekel, okay? Shekel is half an ounce. So 15 shekel is like 7 ounces of silver. So I look it up. How much is an ounce of silver right now, going price? $40, about $300. One bag of barley, $10. Sorry, $300. Her utility, her value, her market value, it's so low. It's less than my iPad. I can buy two Gomo right now. Her value dropped. I'm pretty sure once she was hot. Once I think she was hot, but now the value dropped. That's what sin does to you. You are made in the image of God. We are made glorious. And we are made to love God. And then what? What does? You do random stuff. And then your value drops. I think this is one of the tragic stories of the humankind. And then I want to think about three things. First of all, who God is, who is God, and who we are. And of course, we will do Luke 24:44 test, okay? Who is God? In this story, who is God? Hosea, who is Hosea? Husband of Gomer. Says in chapter 2, it says, in that day declares the Lord, you will call me my husband. Who's God here? God is portrayed as your husband. So, based on this one, who are married people? Raise your hand. Everybody's married. Whether you know or not. You have husband. And husband and wife is the most want to really think about God in this passage. Who is God? And basically, the whole Bible says God is love. And what is love? What is love? And then you can look at the 1 Corinthians chapter 15, but I think in this part already everything there. God is your lover, your husband. God is one who comes to you and marry you. And that God is one who is patient, loves you, ignores all your mistake, does not divorce. God knows everything. Still, God comes to you. And then, especially chapter 3:1 is most moving, because the Lord said to her, go and then yell at her. Said, you deserve what you got right now. And it says, go, show yourself, show your love to your wife, and then I'll give you the most profound word, again. Hosea cannot do this. Hosea cannot love his wife again. Because she has done too much harm for her, for him, and her children. But God says, go. Show your love to your wife again. Though she is loved by another, and is an adulteress. Love her as the Lord loves the Israelites. And this is our God. And then what the Lord said. So he goes. And then he opens his bank account. Gomer does not deserve 15 shekels. She has to pay Hosea so many things. Gomer does not even deserve one bag of barley, okay? But Hosea buys a bag. I thought this is crazy. Absolutely crazy. And where is justice? Where is... Are you crazy? I look at, okay. Show love your wife, okay? This love is emotionally drained, financially bad, and it's not rational. Because you know, the past predicts the future. Suppose you are a bad student in Korea. You've been flunked out of high school and you come here. The chance of you flunking out in high school is high or low? I think he'll succeed in here or fail here. Okay, let's have Paul, okay? So he's a D minus student, okay? And he comes here. What is success of success? Oh, suppose make it easy, okay?